before we start, turn on closed captions below or above so that you can understand what I'm speaking in Hebrew and French. Shalom. Baruch haba YouTube channel Shali. Ani Saudi va ani ohevet lilmod safot. Ani lomedet ivrit. Ani ohevet liktov va likro ivrit. Ha'alef bet yefet meod. Ani yakola ledaber katsat. Va ani mevina ivrit leat. Hayom ani shota frosty me brew society. Toda rabba va lehitraut. Hi there. Today I wanted to talk about my 2 months learning Hebrew, where I wanted to go from here, and my progress with my other languages. If you're new to this channel, welcome. Please like the video and subscribe for more of my content. So for my first month learning Hebrew, I used HebrewPod 101's Absolute Beginner course, which is their A1 course. And I wrote a review on that, which I've linked below, if you're interested in using any of the Pod 101 websites to learn a language. I've used HebrewPod 101 and HindiPod 101 so far. I finished the course in about a month, so I paid for a 1 month trial period of HebrewPod 101, and now that that's over, I want to use the free plan to boost my vocabulary and my reading skills. So I'm gonna be spending the summer brushing up on my Hebrew vocabulary and starting to practice speaking. So as far as I can tell, the big grammar things that I have left for Hebrew are learning the past and future tenses of verbs. I will admit, the Hebrew verbs scare me. Like, I haven't really felt this way about a language's grammar since I found out about German's cases, and those were hard. So I tried to study Hebrew for about an hour a day during my first month using HebrewPod 101. I made lots of flashcards for vocabulary and reviewed them whenever I had time. And I learned a lot of the basic grammar skills and vocabulary to have basic conversations with people. I didn't get much speaking practice with native speakers, but where I tried to make up for that was while I studied with my flashcards, I would try to make sentences out loud with the vocabulary word. And the verbs. Oh, the verbs. So I actually have my verb flashcards with me right here. So each card has the infinitive, and then the conjugation for the masculine and feminine in the singular in the present tense, and then the three-letter root. And then on the back, I have the definition in English, so this is to come, the pronunciation of the infinitive, and then the pronunciation of the masculine and the feminine form. So it's a lot, I know. I feel a little overwhelmed as well by all of these Hebrew verbs, and this was all just for the present tense, so I haven't figured out yet how I'm gonna learn the past and future tenses. If anyone has good resources on learning Hebrew verbs, please send them my way because I am frankly overwhelmed. So there was one interesting thing that happened with Hebrew during my first month learning it. I was road tripping through the Southwest with a friend of mine, and we stopped at a bodega in the middle of nowhere, like right outside Death Valley Park. And I bought Pringles, and the Pringles can had some writing in Hebrew on it. I could generally make out the words kosher, milk, and food using just my first 3 weeks of learning Hebrew. And I asked a friend of mine, and he said, it says, the dairy is kosher for those who eat non-Jewish dairy. So yeah, I generally understood the words for kosher, food, and milk, which I think is enough to get the general gist of what's going on. So going forward, I found these really cute children's books in Hebrew on the New York Public Library app, so I was going to work my way through those. I started The Tortoise and the Hare the other day, and it took me 10 minutes to read two sentences, so eventually I'll get to the point where I can read children's books. Okay, moving on. So my Hindi goals. So in this video where I talked about my 2021 language goals, I said that I wasn't gonna learn Hindi further. I felt happy with my level at the time, but I moved to New York City in January and have made a lot of Indian friends, and a lot of them banter or joke around in Hindi. So I've had a lot of exposure to it, and I really want to become fluent in Hindi so I can talk to all of them. So I've been learning Hindi for the last couple months, chatting with friends or talking to waiters at Indian restaurants, and of course, watching Bollywood movies. And I think my level has improved. I can definitely communicate with people a lot more than I could before, and I can understand almost everything that's being said to me. Throughout this summer, I'm gonna keep learning Hindi very passively, so just chatting with people or learning really basic grammar and practicing my reading skills. Le prochain français, je vais étudier français très intensivement pendant l'été et j'ai un vidéo ici sur mon progrès avec mon ami Kasia. Donc, je ne vais parler beaucoup sur le français. So lastly, I lumped German and Spanish together because they are currently my best foreign languages that I can speak. I've noticed my level in both has definitely slipped while I was focusing on Hindi, Hebrew, and French. So I want to spend the summer brushing up on German and Spanish and bringing my level back up to where it used to be, so conversationally proficient. I'm planning on taking a speaking course for German and Spanish this summer because I really don't have many people I can practice with here yet. It is New York, so I'm sure I'll meet people eventually who speak German and Spanish. But for now, I have a German textbook, which I don't have here with me. But for now, I got this Spanish textbook. It's basically Spanish for Spanish speakers, and I got it for $2 at the Strand. So we have to speak about travel, because this channel is also for travel, and I haven't been able to do much of that during the pandemic. But I have some news. I'm actually starting grad school at Columbia University in the fall. Before grad school starts, I'm really hoping the EU opens up to American travelers, which I think they should this summer, but I really want to hop the pond and just do some backpacking before school. So this was my super casual summer languages and travel check-in, and I'm gonna try to do one of these every couple of months to connect with you guys more. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.